G'day and welcome back. Some months ago I refurbished this radiogram, but unfortunately it had a fault from the start. The right-hand output transformer wasn't performing as well as the left, and as the repair progressed, it got to the stage where it virtually wasn't working. So although I finished the video and demonstrated it working, it wasn't working properly. I put out a request if anyone could find a transformer for me, because I couldn't get one locally. About a month ago, this box showed up on my doorstep. I'll take it into my little repair shop and I'll open it up. An extremely nice and helpful man in Germany sent this over. Now, this isn't just the transformers, of course. He sent something else as well. So, double box. That looks good. Oh, hey, look at that. Oh, nice bit of fabric. Good. He's also gifted me another radio, and this is from Romania, I believe, built in Romania. And there's my transformer. There's one. Here's another one. Beautiful. I've got the transformers here. I've put the radio aside. We'll look at that at another video. These came from a gentleman in Germany. He's got a channel and it's called Blitz, Roehre. I've probably murdered that pronunciation, but I believe it means lightning tube or something. So let's have a look and see what we got. Now, he put a lot of work in. He made it a mission to get these for me, and I think he drove halfway across Germany and Switzerland to get them. So I'm just so amazed at the generosity of people. There's one. He sent both over. He sent me two. They're matched. They're out of the same amplifier. There you go. He sent both of these over, so they're matched. It's no good putting my old one with a new one or a different one. I believe these are slightly larger. So I'll get the chassis out. We'll have a look. Here's the chassis, and here is the new transformer. There's one of the old ones there. I think this one was all right, but you can see this transformer is much bigger. But I think there's provision within the chassis to take the larger transformer. I'm going to have to do a lot of study to work out how to rewire this. I pretty much had it in my head when I was working on this thing, because I spent a lot of time in this area. And I think these have center taps and things like that. I believe he said this doesn't have the electrostatic speaker connection, so that'll make it a bit easier. I disconnected the electrostatics in mine, so I don't have to worry about that. I'm hoping you can take these two phenolic boards off and put them on the new transformer and just pick up the windings, wire them into the board. That should be fairly straightforward. I'm going to go away and study the circuit and try and get it back into my head how this all works. I'll come back a bit later. In the meantime, we'll do a bit of a trip down memory lane. It's been a big job. I finally got there only to have that right channel not working, and it's almost stopped working now, so I'm not going to run it any longer. I need to pull it apart, determine what's going on. I don't want to damage those output valves. They're going to cost too much. So there will be a continuation to this video, but it won't be for a little while because I need to buy the parts to repair what's wrong with this thing. But I will put it out eventually, and then I'll put this in its correct setting and we'll play some music on it. All right, so that's what happened in June 21. I got most of the way through the radio and this transformer here started to fail. So by the end of the video, it had pretty much failed completely, and I've just tested it now and it's completely open. Now, I'm concerned that this transformer is bigger than that. This transformer was taken out of a set that still had the same output valves, the ECLL800s. So the primary was okay connected to that, but these secondaries are much bigger. So I think the ratio of the windings is going to be different. So I need to work it out. And I've set up my two voltmeters here. This is the new transformer. I've connected the outputs, the secondaries, to this voltmeter. And I've got the primary connected to this voltmeter. And it's also connected back to my variac, so I can put an AC voltage across this primary and read it on the secondary. The variac's going to go through the dim bulb control. I've put it on full power and I've closed this switch here, so we're going to go directly out. I've wound the variac all the way back. I'll turn it on. I'm going to slowly increase the voltage on this one until I get 1 volt. So we go. It's 0.2, 0.3, 4, 5, 7, it's pretty close. Yeah, 1 volt, that'll do. Now hopefully you can read that. It's just on 50, looks like about 52 volts. We're on that lower scale there, so I'll say 52 volts. So that means the ratio on this one is 52:1. So I'll swap these connections over to the good one that's in the set at the moment. I've taken away the old transformer. I've connected onto the working transformer in the radio. So we'll try that out. I'll put some power on. And once again, we're looking for 1 volt there. That's close enough. I made a mistake before when I read this. I said 52. It was actually 55, probably 56. This one's 62 odd. So that means the original output transformer ratio was, what did I say, 62. And this one was 55, probably 56. So there's not a lot of difference there. Now that's over the entire primary winding. So each winding is actually half of that. So that's 31. And this one's 28. To compare the two ratios, I've loaded my output transformer load calculator. I'll put a link to it in the description, but unless you've got a full version of Excel in your computer, it's not going to work. Circled down here is the method, so you don't really need the calculator. So what I do is type in the effective load that that ECLL800 requires. You get that out of the valve data. And for this one, it's about 5,000. And we come over here, and I've got 4 ohm in there at the moment, but the speakers fitted to the unit work out to about 5.3. That says we need a target turns ratio of 30.7. And in the old one, we had 31, so that's pretty close. And the new one is 28. Transformer that was fitted originally is this green one. It's 5,093, so it's only 93 ohm over the calculation, so my guess on the speaker impedance is probably pretty close. This one down here is the new transformer, and it's about 850 below what it should be. I don't think that's going to make a huge difference. That may increase the distortion slightly, but I'll check it when we get the speakers connected up into the radiogram, and I'm pretty sure it'll be all right. Now, having re-familiarized myself with this, it's going to be easy. It's just really 4 wires on each transformer, and I'll try and remount them. As I said earlier, I think this bracket comes off and reveals mounting for the larger transformer. Let's have a look. We'll get this board out of the way. There's 2 screws there. It looks like it just slides in on that side, so I'll undo the 2 screws. I should be able to slide that sideways, I think. There we go. Okay. And there's the new one. Doesn't fit very well. It doesn't line up with any holes that are in there. I thought it might line up with some of the old holes. It might be better to mount it back on this bracket. I'll take the transformer off the bracket and mount it back in that. Now, wires. Those ones are okay. They're already free. And here's the 2 power supply wires, so I'll cut those. Here's the wires for the electrostatic. I'll cut those off. I'll clean those up in a second. Here's the old transformer and its bracket, and this new transformer's not wide enough to go across the gap that this left, and it's almost a bit too wide for the plate. But I think I can still drill some holes in the bracket, and I'll mount this on. I'll just take this old transformer off. So I'll get out in the workshop and do that. I'll come back in a second. I've mounted the transformer on the bracket, and I'll slip it in here, and it should be okay if I can find the holes. Okay, that fits, and I've left some clearance there. I might just bend that away a little bit. I've got to take this out again to get the other one out because the nut's underneath here. All right, there's a nut there. I think I can just undo that, and it's got a split in the mounting, I think. Okay, well, there's the other screw, and I think I'll have to get underneath and grab onto the nut. That might be all right. I might be able to just make the nut stay there long enough. That's it. Now, this one hasn't been split, but there's a little, there we go, little channel around there. There we go. Okay, that's given me a bit of room. I've refitted this one here, so that lines up roughly where it is. There's one hole there that's got to pick up, and this one's got a big slot, and I'm pretty sure it'll fit. Now, when Blitz found these. He said they're bigger, make sure they're going to fit. That looks good there. And I came and measured it, and sure enough, it seemed to be okay. And we're right here. Yeah. So that's fine. I'll just put some screws in there. So I'll take this one out, screw that one down. We're looking good. I've got the transformers mounted, and I've actually skipped ahead a bit. I've put all the wires on. These are the two original phenolic plates with all the components on it. All the center taps went on there. There's ground, so the secondary grounds went on here. The secondaries for the speaker went on here and here. And then I've run the wires back to the valve, the primaries. So I didn't bore you with all that stuff. I've wired underneath, so it's actually ready for a test. I haven't bent these little tags over yet. I'll wait till I've tested it first before I do that. I'm all set up as well. While I had it upside down, I put some clips on it so I can put the speaker on here. So we're ready to go. I've put a couple of little indicators there so you can see them vibrating and make sure they're roughly even. I'll put power on. I don't think it's turned on. No, so medium wave. The lights have come on. 32 watts. The bulb's gone down. So far, so good. I've forgotten how to work it. Oh, there you go.
Changed my life regarding race relations as well as respect for the environment. Valet David, very missed. Thanks for getting in touch. The text line is 0467922.
They're both working.
Clark's taking a road trip into the heart of Australian country music. The self-confessed girl is on a journey to find out how country music has shaped our nation.
Oh, that's terrific. Just try a radio station, or sorry, music station.
Good evening, this is your recliner rocker, Dave D. Whitcomb. That's from back in the days you'd cram six people in a combi van, surfboards on the roof, and not a care in the world. Turn up the radio. It's another jukebox Saturday night with the sugar sugar supplied by the Archies.
This is sweet like sugar. Now... Oh, it hasn't got FM, this one. I forgot. All right. So it's AM only. But they're both working. They're both working good. These are actually 4-ohm speakers, so the one in the radiogram is a bit higher. So if we're okay with these, it'll certainly be all right with the one in the radiogram. Now, what I just realized was we're not on full power yet. I'll put it on full power. Yeah, that was running at 181 volts. 230, that's okay. And about 50 watts, that's pretty good. Volume.
Induction dance response to Dark Emu in 2018. So,
look at that. That is the first time they've ever stayed in unison.
She's been great.
Fantastic. I'm really excited. So I'll refit this back in the case and we'll try it out. I've put the radio back in and polished the cabinet a bit, and it's ready to test. I'll put it on medium wave. And fingers crossed.
Have a look online and pick your favourite moments, but Mitchell Johnson is a big one there. Got some lovely highlights of that time to bring to you as well. That...
I haven't got a good aerial on this, it's going to struggle a bit.
So, 40 golden worm. It's $7.50 for one Timmy Martin and four Leroy Renegade, $8.50. Favorite six Bone Master, $1.75. They are moving in.
So that's working perfectly. Both speakers are working equally. So I'm really happy now. I'm going to try the record player. All right, let's have a go. Now, of course, I can't play that.
By his little pigtail and on his knees fell he.
sunshine. As we merrily dance and we sing, tra-la, we welcome the hope that they bring.
Okay, sounds really good. It's working perfectly. I'll try another record. As I said, I can't play these, they won't let me. That's about all I can play. I'm sorry. The radio is working fantastically. I have had this sitting here for 6 months and just couldn't wait to get it going. And thanks to Blitz over in Germany, I owe him a million. He's been fantastic. So thanks to Blitz, and say hello to Blitz when you're on the comments. Before I go, I'm going to unpack that Romanian radio that Blitz kindly sent over. Here's the Romanian radio that Blitz has sent me. So I'll just unpack it and just have a sneak peek at it. He did a video on his channel about this, and he checked it to make sure it was going to basically work and he wasn't sending me a dud that I couldn't fix. So if you have a look at his channel, you can see him working on this, or at least testing it. Now, unfortunately, the video is in German, but you can get the basic idea. I'll get rid of the bubble wrap. So, is it upside down? Might be upside down. Oh, it's wooden. It's a wooden radio. I thought it was Bakelite. As I said, this is was made during communism in the Eastern Bloc, so a bit interesting. Just spin it around. Oh, look, magic eye. Oh no, there's no knob. Here's the knobs. Oh, he's packed it all up. Wow. So he's put little, goodness me, what a great job. Oh, they're going to need a bit of work. There's something wrong with those. It's called a Carmen 2, made by Electronica. So this is going to be very interesting. The cloth's in good condition. Yeah, magic eye. Wow, this is exciting. I'll just quickly have a look at the back and we'll see what's there. I think he's packed stuff inside there for me. I'm going to leave this radio at this stage. This is a bit of a teaser. I'm not going to do this the next one, I don't think. It's another one I've got in the pipeline that I'm still finishing off. But looking forward to this. This one's going to be a bit different to what I normally look at. So I'm really looking forward to it. Now, can I just say to Blitz, Blitz isn't his real name, of course, unless his mum and dad called him Lightning. Just thank you so much. I really appreciate all the work you did trying to find a radio to send out to me. He's been doing this for months. And he sent the transformers out. He covered all the costs. He's just an amazing man. I'll leave a link to Blitz's channel in the description. And if you feel like it, just pop over and say hello. Really nice man. Really nice. I hope you enjoyed this shorter video. There's probably not a lot in it, but I'm really happy to get my radiogram going. Once again, thanks Blitz. And if you did enjoy it, I hope you can join me for my next radio adventure, which won't be this.